Good day, farmers. I'd like to welcome you to the first of I'm not sure how many videos I'm going to make about this the subject, but let me just give you a quick breakdown of why I'm doing this. For me, I've been using Excel for many years, and it's been a valuable tool inside my business or my part of the business. And when I started out using Excel many years ago, it was very difficult for me to find good information or good quality training information that related to my business, my area of business. So I'm in the poultry industry, and I'm farming on a daily basis, and it was very difficult for me to find Excel training videos that related to production, poultry production related numbers. And there was a lot of information regarding other sectors, you know, other industries, clothing industries and so on, but it never really fully translated into the knowledge that I wanted to gain, with using Excel. It was always talking about this salesman sold that amount of white t-shirts for that specific month of the year, and that wasn't relevant for me. I struggled with the formulas, and it was difficult for me to get to the information that I specifically needed. Okay, so there isn't really a lot of information on the internet regarding poultry production numbers in Excel. So what I thought about doing was, you know, if there is somebody that is sitting in the same boat as I were, you know, a couple of years ago, not fully understanding the information that is being given to you inside the training material that you are using, I'm hoping that this would be able to help you as a fellow poultry farmer. Okay, so what we're going to do is I'm going to go through these two formulas that I use on a daily basis. It's going to be the SUMIFS, and it's going to be the index and match. Index and match formula. I use these two formulas very extensively throughout my part of the business, specifically on smaller daily reports that I send out to whomever needs to look at the information. I really hate making life difficult for myself. Okay, so I try to make it as easy as possible for me. My information that I input in my sheets, I find ways to make that easy for me, fast, so that I can just do it and get it over with, and then obviously send away the emails. That's why you'll see that within this specific report, it's break down into three sheets. Okay, so I've got my data set. I've got a list sheet over here, which is just information that I reference in the data validation formulas, and then obviously my output sheet, which is the daily sheet over here. Okay, I've got a little picture of a rooster over here. It's got a macro assigned to it, so if I click on the rooster, it brings up my input form, and it selects the date for today automatically. You'll see that it references the farm names. Now, it pulls these farm names from this list over here. Okay, so whatever I change in here, if I put in there farm 6, if you open up the input user form, you'll actually see there's farm 6 now there as well. Okay, so that just makes it easy for me to add or remove farm names. Then obviously total eggs, hatching eggs, female mortalities, male mortalities, and then comments. Okay. So if I finish inputting the information here and I hit submit, it basically sends it through to the sheet over here right at the bottom. It's a table. It's a table, so it automatically adapts to the information that I sent in to the new information, and it just adds a new row. And that is basically that for this. If I click on clear form, it'll clear everything, so I can start fresh with a new form. It won't delete the date, because it's still on the same day. But that was just a quick overview of exactly what this report does. What I want you guys to focus on within this video is the two formulas that we're going to use, the SUMIFS, as well as the array formula called index and match. Okay, so I really, really do hope that you can use this information and learn at least something. Something, even if it's one thing that you can use, even if it's not on a daily basis, you know. But as long as you can use this information, if it's relevant to what you do on a daily basis. Right, so let's start then with the two formulas. Let's then start with the first formula that I want to show you. It's going to be the SUMIFS formula. Basically what we want to do in both of these instances, we would like to reference some information from the data sheet over here, and then we would like to pull in whatever variables we actually give it. Inside the formula, we would like to reference that that corresponding cell containing that information in the data sheet. Right, so let's have a look at what we want to do. We would like to import the amount of female mortalities inside the cell, HV4. We'd like to import the amount of female mortalities for a specific farm. In this case, the farm name is farm 1, for a specific date. Okay, so it's going to be the total amount of female mortalities for farm 1 for a specific date. All right. So let's have a look at how we're going to do that with the SUMIFS formula. We're going to go equals SUMIFS. Then, first of all, oopsie-daisy, there's a semicolon. All right, so go back. So first of all, what we're going to do is we're going to go back into the data sheet. We're going to select the column where the answer is, okay? So that's going to be this column over here, the female mortality column, okay? Right, so we select that one. Going to use a comma. Then what we're going to do is we're going to start referencing the variables that we are using. So first of all, we're going to look for the farm name column inside the data sheet. Here we go. It's column B. Press column, comma, go back to daily. Then we would like to, obviously we just selected the farm name column. So now we would like to reference the criteria for that specific criteria range, which is going to be, and it's going to be difficult because you won't be able to see it there, but it's going to be farm 1, which is going to be HU4. There we go. So as you can see, I've selected that cell over there. I'm going to use the comma again, then criteria range 2, which is going to be the date range. Okay, so we're going to go back to sheet 1, select the date range or the date column over there, which is going to be column A. Use the comma again, go back to daily, select the date cell, then close it with the brackets, the closing brackets, and there we go. So let's have a look now. According to this, it says farm 1 at 10 female mortalities on June 3rd for this year. Okay, so farm 1, 10 female mortalities for that specific date, which is June 3rd. Let's go and have a look at the data sheet. So 10 female mortalities. All right, farm 1 for June 3rd. There we go, at 10 female mortalities. If we go and we select a different date, let's select date 2. You'll see the information changes now. There we go, so it's 11 female mortalities. Just close this. Thank you, Microsoft. So for farm 1, on the 2nd of June, we had 11 female mortalities. So let's go and have a look at the data sheet. The 2nd of June for farm 1, there we go, is 11. Let's do another one. Let's take the 30th. 30th of May. 6 female mortalities for farm 1. Let's go and have a look at the 30th for farm 1. There we go. 6 female mortalities. And that's basically that. Okay then, let's have a look at the second formula. The second formula, which is going to be the index and match formula. Now this is, personally, this is my favorite formula to use. Use it every day, I use it during the day as well. It's just a fantastic formula that it never disappoints. Sends out the correct information time after time again. Right, so let's have a look at how we're going to do this. So what information are we looking for? We're looking for the total amount of eggs for farm one for a specific date. So the total amount of eggs for farm one on a specific date. All right, so let's start with this. First of all, we're going to use the index formula. We're going to use the array. Let's select the array where the information is found inside the data sheet, which is going to be, I'm not going to use the farm name and the date now. We're going to reference that a little bit later. So what we're going to do is I'm going to basically then select this array here with all of that information. I'm going to press comma. Okay. Then we're going to start with the match, the match formula inside this formula. Okay, so there we go. Match. Okay, so what match basically does is it references the row number inside the array according to the other variables that you specify within the formula. Okay, so let's have a look what match does. We're going to look up the value. What value are we going to look up? Now, this is where the fun starts, because we've got two values. Okay, we've got the farm name and we've got the date. Okay. With one value, it's easy. You just select it, and you select the lookup array. But with two, there's a bit of a trick. So first of all, we're going to do the farm name. Okay. So let's select the farm name. Again, the formula bar is in the way there, so I'm going to just use my cursor keys to get back to farm one. What I'm going to do then is I'm going to press Shift and 7, which is the ampersand sign there. So it's farm name. And then select the date cell. Okay, so it's farm name and date. Great. Right. The lookup array is going to be inside the data sheet again. So what we're going to do is I'm going to select farm 4 over there. Then I'm going to press Shift, Control, and down arrow key to select all of the information in that specific column inside this table. Okay. I'm going to use Shift 7 again to get AND. Then I'm going to go up, because now we've got the references, the farm name inside that column. Okay. Now we're going to reference the date, which we've already put into after the AND sign there. So now we're going to reference the date column, Control Shift and down to select all the information there. Press comma. Now we need an exact match. Okay. After you press the comma, you'll see this little drop-down menu appear here. Select the 0, which is the exact match. I just select it and I double click it. And then I'm going to close it. There we go. We've done one index and match. We need another one. So what we're going to do is, after this formula here, we don't press enter or anything like that yet. We're going to do another match, another match formula. Right. So we're going to select match. Press tab to get the opening brackets. Then what are we going to reference now? We'd like to still see the total eggs inside the first array that we selected. Okay, so we're going to pull that information out for those two values that we specified. Right, so how are we going to do this? First of all, we're going to select total eggs. Okay, then press comma. Right, make sure that this total eggs is spelled the same as it is here in this cell. Okay, total eggs spelled the same. Right. So we're going to do is we're going to select the row array over here. All of these ones over here. All right. Press comma. Then select. I'll just double, like I said, I double click this exact match and it selects it. I press Shift and 0 for two closing brackets. Now, what you need to do is don't press enter. Okay. Because now we are working with arrays here. We need to use another function or another way of actually validating this information. And what are we going to do? We're not going to press enter. We are going to press Control Shift and enter. Boom. So let's have a look. Okay, let's have a look now. If let's say I didn't press Control Alt Delete, I just press entered, it's going to bring a value error. Okay, so if I go up to that again, select the formula, press Control Shift and enter, the information comes through. Okay, please remember that, it's very important. Right, so let's go back to sheet 1. First of all, let's have a look. On the 30th of May, for farm 1, we had this amount of total eggs, 21,893.
30th of May for farm one. Farm one, there we go, 21,893. 100% correct. Let's select another date. There we go, 1st of June. Farm one, okay, total eggs 21,777 on the 1st for farm one. 21,777. Never fails. And that's basically that, guys. Okay. Like I said, this is just a very basic report that I, daily production report that I always use. And what I'd normally do then is I would just select all of this information. You can even select a little rooster in there as well. Okay, I control C. I'll go to my email, open up the email, and just control V, paste it in there, select whoever needs to get this information, and I send it off. And there we go. You got all your production information for that specific day, for all of those specific farms. You've got your female mortalities, your male mortalities, your total eggs, the total egg difference from the previous day to today. I'll show you in another video how to do that. You got your rejects in there, and then obviously your reject percentage, and then your hatching eggs. Okay, all of this information I'll show you in another video that I'll be doing in the near future. All I wanted to do now was I wanted to show you guys the two formulas that I normally use on a daily basis. It's going to be the SUMIFS, and it's going to be the index and match. There you go. I hope you guys can use this information. And if you need any help, any assistance, you're very welcome to contact me. I'm going to leave my contact details in the information box. And there we go. I hope you guys can use this information. Thank you very much.